a very good morning to all of you. So my first question from you is that, is everything okay technically? Is my sound clearly audible to you or not? So please tell me that first, and then we will begin the session for important committees. A good morning to every one of you, Shilpa, Sayyad, Arnab, Gagandeep, Upnita, all of you. Okay, a very good morning, and let's begin the session, which includes all the important committees for the upcoming RBI Grade B examination. And in this session, we will be covering the committees through questions. So let's begin this session. But before that, if you are coming for the first time in this session, as I see that many of the students are there, they are my regular students, but some of you are new here. So those who are new, guys, you can subscribe and hit this bell notification so that you get the instant updates about the upcoming sessions that we are going to upload on our YouTube channel. And guys, in the coming days, we have a lot of important sessions for you for the upcoming RBI examination. So if you don't want to miss those sessions, then subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes, as I have already told you guys many times. And here, this is the doubt resolving platform. So if you have any doubts, you can ask us on this channel. And this is the RBI Grade B crash course that we have for the upcoming examination. And we have 40% discount right now running on this course. So if you want to avail this opportunity, then use this crash 40 coupon code in order to get the 40% discount. Okay. So this is our first question, and guys, this PPT will be provided to the students in the course, and this PPT will help you in your revision in the last time, in the last moment. So let's begin this question with this first, this video with this first question. Okay. Who heads the advisory committee formed by RBI for managing the Payments Infrastructure Development Fund scheme? So you have the five options, and this question we have already discussed. This is a very recent committee formed in the year 2021, and we have the options BP Kango, MD Patra, MK Jain, NS Vishwanathan, M Rajeshwar Rao. So which one is the right answer? Absolutely right. Yes, Naveen, this is the first session on committees, and in this session, I will be covering all the important committees. So there would not be any part two of this session. So do listen to me very carefully till the end of this session. Okay, absolutely right, guys. It's option A, BP Kango. Next. Who heads the IRDAI's 10-member Health Insurance Advisory Committee? This committee again was formed in the year 2021, and therefore it is a very recent committee and an important one. So we have Subhash Chandra Khuntia, Keshav Pratap Rathore, Ritesh Singh, Kamal Bhadoria, Raghav Deshmukh. Which one is the right answer? Absolutely right, Shilpa. 345 crore is the corpus of Payment Infrastructure Development Fund. Very good, guys. So this corpus is important. You have to remember the corpus as well. Absolutely right. It's A. Subhash Chandra Khuntia, who is also the chairman of IRDAI. Who heads the 7-member committee formed by the Ministry of Education for exploring the option of conducting a common entrance test for admission to undergraduate colleges across all central universities from the next academic year? So again, this is an important committee formed in the year 2021. You have PM Muralidharan, Pradeep Singh Kharola, RP Tiwari, Manju Sharma, or U Murugan. What is the right answer? Himanshu, this is not a very, I would say that RBI has not compartmentalized the topics. You don't have the clear demarcation that these much questions will come from this topic. So committees usually have 1 to 2 questions in the examination, but 1 to 2 marks are also important for you to gain. Okay, absolutely right. It's Aarti Tiwari. Who heads the government's 10-member empowered committee for administration of COVID-19? This again was recently formed in the year 2021. So we have Vishal Singh, Arish Sharma, Piyush Goyal, Amitabh Chaudhary and Nishant Goyal. Who heads this empowered committee, which includes 10 members for the administration of COVID-19? Absolutely right. It's option B, R.S. Sharma. Very good, guys. Who heads the South Asia Group for Energy? Anil Yadav, Suraj Prakash Sharma, Ram Vinay Shahi, Gaurav Shukla, Astik Sinha. You have the 5 options, and remember that this too was formed in the year 2021. So I have arranged the questions in a chronological manner. So all the committees that have been formed in the year 2021 will come first, and then we have 2020, and then we have committees prior to 2020. Okay. Absolutely right. It's option C, Ram Vinay Shahi. Okay, so someone is asking about the Articles of Constitution. Articles of Constitutions were on the questions on articles, were those questions that were in the news. For example, I remember there was a question on Article 15 as well. So Article 15, I guess there is a movie of Ayushman Khurana. So the articles which are in news, only those articles are important. So you have to prepare only those articles, and you don't have to prepare it separately, because I provide all the articles of constitution that are in the news in Spotlight magazine. So if you are preparing from Spotlight, then you don't have to go for other sources. Absolutely right, Shilpa. V.K. Paul wali committee on COVID-19, R.A. Sharma is also a member of that committee. So we will be discussing V.K. Paul committee as well in the later part of this video. Okay, absolutely right. It's option C, and this was found in 2021. Who heads RBI's group on digital lending? N. Vishwanathan, Bimal Jalan, Jayant Kumar Dash, Rosie Nambiar, Krishn Dev. Who heads this digital lending committee of RBI? 2021 is the year of formation. Absolutely right. It's option C, Jayant Kumar Dash. And some people are saying option A as well. I guess you are confused, because this committee was also formed recently. And which committee is it? That we will discuss through a question in the later part of this video, when we will witness the question related to N. Vishwanathan. Okay. Who heads the group of ministers formed by the government to review the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana and suggest measures to improve it? So you have Smriti Irani, Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, Narendra Singh Tomar, Amit Shah and Rajnath Singh. Who heads this committee? Everyone, I see that many of you are going with the Minister of Agriculture, that is Narendra Singh Tomar, but that is not the right answer. It's option E, Rajnath Singh. The committee to review Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana was formed by the government and chaired by Rajnath Singh, and the year of formation is 2020. Next, who heads the committee formed by Supreme Court to frame a law on mediation to give legal sanctity to disputes settled through mediation. So you have option A, Saurav Kumar Singh, Niranjan Bhatt, Neeraj Mishra, Bharat Kumar and Anurag Bakshi. Which one is the right answer? Okay, only one answer. Nilesh has given the answer, but what about the other people who are watching this session right now? Okay, now everybody is mentioning Niranjan Bhatt. So is it the right answer, guys? Or you all are confident that Niranjan Bhatt is the right answer? Okay, so you all are right. It's option B, Niranjan Bhatt, who is the chair of this committee formed by Supreme Court. And the year of formation is 2020. Months are not important. The year of formation, the month of formation of the committee is not important. Just the year is important. Next. Who heads the committee formed by the government for transforming the Indian Academy of Highway Engineers into a world-class premier institute on highway sector? So YS Malik, Jagan Mohan, BS Reddy, YK Mehrotra and Piyush Duggal are in the options. Which one is the right answer? And the year of formation of this committee is 2020. Absolutely right. It's option A, YS Malik. So it seems that you have prepared the committee's document that we provide on our Infinity portal thoroughly. And that is a really good thing. Okay. Who heads the technology group formed to advise ministries, departments and PSUs on technology implementation? Rajiv Kumar, K. Vijay Raghavan, Shivam Tiotia and Ajit Pal, R.P. Singh. Which one is the right answer? Absolutely right, guys. It's B, K. Vijay Raghavan, and the year of this committee is 2020. Who heads the Municipal Bonds Development Committee formed by SEBI to find out ways for the development of primary and secondary market of municipal debt securities? So you have Sujit Prasad, Valika Mehta, Priyam Dewal, Migakshi Mishra, Manjima Khaitan. Who heads this Municipal Bonds Development Committee, which was formed in the year 2020? Okay, so only four people have answered and all the answers are different. Some are saying B, Valika Mehta. Some people are saying Ramesh Pokhriyal, which is not even in the options. Okay guys, so the right answer to this question is option A, Sujit Prasad. The committee set up by Ministry of Tribal Affairs to examine the Community Forest Resources Guidelines 2016 and suggest measures to simplify them. So you have Pramod Kumar, NC Saxena, Sanjay Agarwal, Tarun Sridhar, NC Gautam. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option B, NC Saxena. And the year of formation is 2020. Next. Who is the chairman of the group formed by IRDAI to explore the possibilities of allowing insurance companies to sell indemnity-based health policies? So you have G. Srinivasan, Vishnu R. Dasad, A. Valayan, Anand Mahindra, Himanshu Mishra. Which one is the right answer? Absolutely right. It's option A, G. Srinivasan, and the year of formation is 2020. Who heads the 16-member committee formed by IRDAI to improve corporate governance systems of insurers, primarily on making key functions such as risk management and internal audits independent of each other? So you have Praveen Kutum, Subhash C. Kuntia, Rashid Khan, Prahlad Singh, Zain Abdullah. Who heads this committee? Absolutely right. It's option A, Praveen Kutum, and the year of formation is 2020. Next, who heads the 3-member high-level committee formed by Ministry of Petroleum to inquire about the blast at a gas well of Oil India Limited in Assam? So where was this gas well blasted? It's the place called Bagh. So this is the name of the place, Baghjan, where the gas well of Oil India Limited blasted, and for inquiring the blast, this committee was formed. So you have B.C. Bora, T.K. Sen Gupta, P.K. Mishra, S.C.L. Das and Deep Kumar in the options. Which one is the right answer? Who heads this committee? Good. It's SCL Das. And the year of formation is 2020. Who heads the committee formed by NGT, National Green Tribunal, to look into the recent fire at Oil India Limited well in Baghjan, Assam? So two committees to inquire the same purpose, to inquire the same blast, were formed, one by Ministry of Petroleum and second by National Green Tribunal. Now who heads this committee formed by NGT? So you have Justice Jayant Nath, Justice Mukta Gupta, Sanjeev Sachdev, BP Kartike and Vibhu Bakru. Who heads this committee? Okay. Absolutely. It's option B, Justice BP Kartike, and the year of formation is 2020. Who heads the 9-member committee formed by IRDAI to recommend insurance cover for drone operators or owners. So you have Ketki Kanpan, Manohar Lal, Jignesh Parikh, Bhupesh Rawal or Anjan Day. Who heads this committee for drone operators? Okay, sir. Absolutely right, guys. It's Anjan Day. I hope, Shilpa, that the background noise is reduced now. So if there is any problem, then mention it here. Okay. Anjan Day. Absolutely right. And the year of formation is 2020. Who heads the committee formed by Government of India to effectively implement the rupees 3 lakh crore collateral free loan scheme for MSMEs? So this was part of the relief package. So you have Piyush Goyal, Nirmala Sitaraman, Rajnath Singh, Narendra Singh Tomar or Atanu Chakrabarty. So these are the five people who heads this committee. Absolutely. It's Rajnath Singh and the year of formation is 2020. Who heads the committee for reform in criminal law formed by the Ministry of Home Affairs? So this is an important committee, guys. Committee for reform in the criminal law. Ranveer Singh, Komal Patra, Kishan Singh, Giriraj Mukherjee and Kesha Pandey are the options. Who heads this committee? Good. It's option A. Ranveer Singh heads this committee and the year of formation is 2020. Who has been appointed as the chief of National Human Rights Commission's committee to study the impact of COVID-19 on human rights and suggest future response of the government? So you have P.K. Mohan, K.S. Reddy, J.S. Singhal, P.R. Trivedi and Piyush Shergill in the options. Who heads this committee? Okay, so everyone is saying option A. Vishal is saying option C, J.S. Singhal. So the right answer here is option B, K.S. Reddy, and all of you are wrong here. It's K.S. Reddy who has been appointed as a chief of this committee. The year of formation is 2020. Every committee related to COVID was formed in the year 2020. So there is no effort from your side to memorize the year of formation of those committees. Okay. Who heads the government committee that was formed to boost research and development in the field of novel drugs? Again, the year is 2020. No effort from our side because the focus on drugs was shifted so much in the year 2020 only. So we have P.D. Vaghela, Nimesh Mehta, Keval Jadhav, Vandana Joshi, Ashima Jain. Who heads this committee? Quickly answer karo taki jaldi jaldi khatam kare hum sare questions. We have over 100 questions in this session. So quickly answer your, give your answers. Okay, guys, it's option A, P.D. Vaghela. Next, who heads the National Expert Group on Vaccine Administration? Rajiv Guba, Ajay Swani, Kaveri Samba, Shiva Rao, V.K. Paul, Anand Sharma. Who heads this committee? National Expert Group on Vaccine Administration. And this is one of the most important groups that we have in 2020, and tell me the chief of this committee. Absolutely right, guys. It's VK Paul and RS Sharma, the head of that 10-member empowered group, is also a member of this national expert group on COVID, sorry, on vaccine administration. Who heads the APEX committee for the implementation of the Paris Agreement? So this is again an important committee of 2020. So you have Rameshwar Prasad Gupta, Sanjay Kumar, Shishir Kumar Rathore, Soumitra Das Gupta, Anjali Nandan Sharan. Who heads this committee for the implementation of Paris Agreement? Good. It's option A, Rameshwar Prasad Gupta. Who heads the committee formed by the Department of Science and Technology to use futuristic and new age technologies for the conservation of Indian heritage? So this was again formed in the year 2020. So we have in the options B.K. Murthy, Rakesh Maheshwari, Arvind Kumar, Shantanu Chaudhary and Jatinder Singh. Who heads this committee? Okay, so it's option D, Shantanu Chaudhary, and he is the director of which IIT? IIT Jodhpur. So this is again an important fact. Next, who is the chair of Central Government's Committee for Strengthening India's Capital Goods Sector? So option A, Rajiv Guba, option B, Krishnendra Pratap Singh, option C, Arun Goyal, option D, Kundan Kumar, option E, Amrendra Tiwari. So who heads this committee that was formed in the year 2020 for strengthening the capital goods sector of India? Absolutely right. It's option C, Arun Goyal. Who heads the committee formed by Ministry of Information and Broadcasting to review the guidelines on television rating agencies in India? So you have Ravi Shankar Prasad, Sanjay Dhotre, Saurabh Kumar and Shashi Shekhar Vempati. Who heads this committee? Good. It's option E, Shashi Shekhar Vempati. He is at present the CEO of which company? He is the CEO of a major company. Tell me the name of the company of which he is a CEO. And the year of formation of this committee is 2020. So this is something that you should memorize. Absolutely right, Rishabh. It's Prasad Bharati. So Shashi Shekhar Vempati is the CEO of Prasad Bharati. Absolutely right. Who is the head of the 3-member interim committee of directors which was appointed by RBI to run the operations of Dhan Lakshmi Bank? So you have P.K. Vijay Kumar, G. Gopal, Raj Gopal Nair, M. Venkateshwar Meena Lakshmi Nair or G. Subramaniam Iyer. Who heads this Dhan Lakshmi Bank Committee of Directors, which was formed in the year 2020 again? Absolutely right. It's option E, G. Subramaniam Iyer. Who heads the SEBI's market data advisory committee formed to ensure that the market data is made more freely accessible to all. So you have N.K. Sodhi, Darius Kambata, M.S. Raghavan, Thomas Matthew, and Madhvi Puri. So who is the right chairperson of this committee? SEBI's Committee on Market Data Advisory. It's very important committee and it was formed in the year 2020. Absolutely right. It's option E, Madhvi Puri. Who has been appointed as the one-man committee by the Supreme Court to curb crop stubble burning in Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh, which chokes Delhi NCR. So basically, it's the one-member committee formed by the Supreme Court in the year 2020. So you have Jagdish Singh Kehar, Deepak Mishra, Madan B. Lockyer, Ranjan Gogoi, or T.S. Thakur. Who is the right answer? Good. It's option C, Madan B. Lockyer. Which committee is preparing the Professional Engineers Bill? Niranjan Bhatt Committee, Shri Y.S. Malik Committee, Ajay Bhushan Pandey Committee, Praveen Gautam Committee, or M.S. Anand Committee? Which committee is preparing the Professional Engineers Bill? Good. It's M.S. Anand Committee. Who heads Niti Aayog's Advisory Committee on Urban Planning Education System? Amitabh Kant, Ayush Dwivedi, Rajiv Kumar, Manohar Pathak, Keshav Ram Sagar. Who heads this Advisory Committee on Urban Planning Education? Okay, so Rishabh has given his answer. What about other people? DS is also saying C. Okay. Nilesh is also saying C. Okay, Ayushi, Shilpa, Akhil. All are going with Rajiv Kumar. Absolutely right, guys. Option C, Rajiv Kumar is the right answer. 2020 is the year. Who heads Niti Aayog's Multidimensional Poverty Index Coordination Committee? Guys, whenever you are discussing any committee, do remember the agency or the organization that has formed that committee, because this Multidimensional Poverty Index Coordination Committee is one of the most important committees formed by Niti Aayog. So this question can also be asked from you, that which of the following government agency has formed this Multidimensional Poverty Index Committee. So that question, you should also know the answer of that question. Okay. So we have Rajeshwari Kothari, Sandeep Mehta, Sayukta Samda, Priya Gangwal, Karan Mehra in the options. Who is the chairperson of this committee? Okay, so I have got the answers. It's option C, Sayukta Samdar, and the year is 2020. Heads the Committee on Food and Beverages formed by Trade Promotion Council of India? R. Sengutuvan, Manish Shah, Mehul Mishra, Lakshman Singh Rathaur, Dev Jyoti Bose. Who heads this committee formed by Trade Promotion Council of India on Food and Beverages? Absolutely right. It's option D. So Rishabh has mentioned the answer correctly. It's D. Okay, so now Nilesh is also saying D. Good, guys. It's Lakshman Singh Rathaur. And the year is 2020. Who heads the high-level committee to prepare a roadmap for regularization of land leasing in the agriculture sector? So you have Ajay Tilke, Praful Raichur, Meghan Parikh, Kaveri Priyam, Mithali Mehta. Who heads this committee? Good. It's option A, Ajay Tilke. And the year is 2020. Central government has formed an expert committee under the National Cyber Security Coordinator Rajesh Pant to study reports of surveillance of Indians by Chinese firms. Which firm is being talked about? So basically, this committee was formed in order to investigate a Chinese firm. Now, which firm is it? The question is asking you that. So you have the five options. All these are five Chinese companies. So you have Zenma Data, ByteDance, Xiaomi, Alibaba, Tencent. Which one is the right answer? Good. It's option A, Zenma Data, and the year is 2020. Who heads the three-member committee of directors appointed by RBI for Lakshmi Vilas Bank to run the operations of Lakshmi Vilas Bank? So we have Meeta Makhan, Shakti Sinha, Satish Kumar Kalara, Preetam Srivastav, Aditya Puri. Who heads this committee of directors? Absolutely right, guys. Meeta Makhan. The other way around this question can be framed is that Meeta Makhan committee was formed by RBI for administration of which bank? So here you should know the answer, that it's Lakshmi Vilas Bank, and you should be prepared for all kinds of questions, all kinds of direction in which the question can be asked from. Okay, so the year of formation is 2020. Next, who heads the International Financial Services Centers Authorities Committee, which has been formed for the development of international retail business in IFSC? So this committee has been in the news since its formation in August 2020. So it has submitted its three interim reports to IFSCA. Now tell me the chairperson of this committee. So you have Pradeep Shah, Meena Kumari, Prakash Gupta, Bhimsen Kothari and Vivek Sinha. Absolutely right, guys. It's option A, Pradeep Shah. And remember this committee. This is an important committee. Who heads the committee formed by RBI to suggest financial parameters to be considered in the restructuring of loans impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic? Again, the year of formation is 2020. No need to focus yourself on the year of formation because it is COVID-19. Okay. Usha Durat, Vayan Diyosthale, Viral Acharya, K.V. Kamath, Tarun Bajaj. Who heads this committee? D. Very good, guys. It's K.V. Kamath. Kamath or Kamath, whatever. Who heads the IRDAI's panel on revising product structures of engineering tariffs relevant for the retail category? So you have Sanjeev Srivastav, R. Chandrasekharan, S.K. Pathak, Yogesh Kumar Bhutta and Anjali Rawat. Who heads this committee? Good. Absolutely right. It's option B, R. Chandrasekharan, and the year of formation is 2020. Who heads the panel formed by SEBI for reviewing the framework of share-based employee benefit and issue of sweat equity? सो यू हैव ए के जयराजन, संदीप भगत, रुबीना अली, के रामाराव एंड गुलशन कुमार इन द ऑप्शंस. हु हेड्स दिस स्वेट कमिटी और स्वेट इक्विटी कमिटी ऑफ सेबी? Absolutely right, guys. It's option B, Sandeep Bhagat. Year is 2020. Who heads the six-member working group formed by IRDAI to study the feasibility and need of index-linked insurance products in India? K.V. Ramamurthy, Dinesh Pant, Prashant Kumar, Nitin Chugh, Mahabaleshwara M.S. Who heads this committee of IRDAI? Good. It's option B, Dinesh Pant, and the year is 2020. Who heads SEBI's technical group on social stock exchange? Harsh Kumar Bhanwal, MD Patra, Ashok Gulati, Alok Sinha, and MV Rao are in the options. And this is one of the important committees of SEBI on social stock exchange. So tell me that who chairs this committee? Good. It's option A, Harsh Kumar Bhanwal, and the year is 2020. Who heads the empowered group of ministers to oversee the process of corporatization of Ordnance Factory Board? So you have Nirmala Sitharaman, S. Jaishankar, Dini Sadanand Gowda, or Rajnath Singh, Ravi Shankar Prasad. Who heads this committee? Good. It's D, Rajnath Singh. Ordnance Factory Board is a defense PSU, so you can easily remember it that Rajnath Singh is the chair of this committee. Who heads the internal working group formed by RBI to review the existing guidelines on ownership, governance, and corporate structure of private sector banks? So you have BP Kanungo, Mahesh Kumar Jain, MD Patra, Dilip S. Shangvi, PK Mohanty in the options. Which one is the right answer? The portion that I have underlined is very important. The ownership, governance, and corporate structure of private sector banks. To review that structure and recommend improvements, for that this panel has been formed. On this question, I would like to have more answers. So, every one of you are going with, almost every one of you are going with PK Mohanty. Absolutely right. Option E is the right answer. And 2020 is the year of formation. Who heads the panel formed by Niti Aayog to provide jobs to the migrant workers? So, you have PK Mishra, Prashant Kanwal, Rajiv Goba, Amitabh Kant, Tia Kandwal in the options. And remember, this committee was formed in the year 2020. Migrant workers, the issue of migrant workers also came into the spotlight because of the COVID-19 pandemic only. Now tell me the year, the chief of this committee. DSBP Kanungo is the head of Payment Infrastructure Development Fund Committee that was formed by RBI. So this question I had taken in the beginning of the session only. ओके सो मेजॉरिटी ऑफ यू आर गोइंग विद राजीव बट दैट इज नॉट द करेक्ट आंसर. द करेक्ट आंसर इज अमिताभ कांत. गाइस कैन यू टेल मी द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ अमिताभ कांत इन नीति आयोग. What position does he hold in Niti Aayog? Tell me that. Absolutely right, Akhil, Shilpa. Very good, guys. Amitabh Kant is the CEO of Niti Aayog and he is chairing this committee, which was formed in the year 2020. Who heads the government's screening panel for investigating all Chinese foreign investment proposals? So this is again an important committee. All the Chinese proposals will be screened by this committee formed by the central government. So you have Ajay Kumar Bhalla, Gurjeet Singh Dhillo, Ravi Singh, Bhuvan Soran and Manoj Shinde in the options. Who heads this committee? No, Ashutosh, it's CEO, not the chairman of Niti Aayog. Absolutely right, guys. It's option A, Ajay Kumar Bhalla. And the year is 2020. Who heads the panel of secretaries formed by the central government for streamlining telecom spectrum allocation process? Panel of secretaries was formed by the central government for that telecom spectrum allocation process. This is again an important committee. Agam Mittal, Ajay Tyagi, Rajiv Goba, Abhinav Gupta, B. Madan Mohan Das are in the options. Which one is the right answer? Good. Absolutely right, DS. Chairman of Niti Aayog is Prime Minister himself. The designation of Prime Minister is the ex officio head of Niti Aayog. Absolutely right. Okay. So Rajiv Goba, option C is the right answer and the year is 2020. Who heads IRDAI's panel on standard cyber liability insurance product? Ayush Tripathi, P. Umesh, Pankaj Sharma, Brijesh Chaudhary, Payal Kanpal, and remember the year is 2020 of this committee. Now tell me the answer. Good. It's option B, P. Umesh. Who heads the government panel formed to study the impact of waiving of the interest on loans during the moratorium offered to the COVID hit borrowers that ended August 31st? So basically this committee was formed in before August 31st in order to study the impact of interest waiver. So you have Rajiv Maharishi, Rampreet Mandal, Dileshwar Kamet, Gopal Ji Thakur, and Dinesh Chandra Yadav. Who heads this committee? Absolutely right. It's option A, Rajiv Maharishi, and the year is 2020. Again, it's talking about moratorium. It's talking about COVID hit borrowers. So the year is 2020. And remember, the committees formed in the 2021 are not as many in number as compared to 2020. So you can easily remember all the committees formed in the year 2021 for COVID. Okay. Who heads IRDAI's working group formed to study the suitability of offering surety bonds to contractors by the insurance companies? So Girish Sachdeva, G. Srinivasan, Vitesh Krishnan, Mahesh Kanpal and Dhruv Prakash are the options. Who is the right answer? Who is the chairman of this committee? Good. It's G. Srinivasan and the year is 2020. Who heads the panel formed by the 15th Finance Commission? This is an important panel, guys. To suggest measures to promote exports of agricultural goods and reduce imports by boosting production. So this panel for agricultural goods export was formed by the 15th Finance Commission itself. Now, who heads this panel? So you have Sanjeev Puri, Shyam Srinivasan, Uday Kotak, Sandeep Bakshi and Amitabh Chaudhary in the options. Tell me the answer of this question. Good. It's option A, Sanjeev Puri, and the year is 2020. Now, who is the chairman of 15th Finance Commission? Tell me that, the name of the person. It's Sanjeev Puri. Yes, absolutely. He's the present chief of ITC company, Sanjeev Puri. Thank you so much, Akhilesh. I am glad that you guys are liking it. And do share it with your friends as well so that they can also get last moment revision of the important topics that we have covered. So till now, we have covered static GK portion. We have covered indices and reports. This is the committees and spotlight sessions till January. So if you have friends that are preparing for the RBI, SEBI and NABARD examination, then do share these sessions with your friends. It's N.K. Singh, Nand Kishore Singh. Absolutely right, guys. 15th Finance Commission is an important one. Okay. Who heads the committee formed by the Ministry of Finance for determining ceiling rates under remission of duties and taxes on exported products scheme? So this scheme has replaced the erstwhile Mercantile Export Incentive Scheme. So this scheme has been replaced by this ROTTEP scheme, and in order to fix the ceiling rates under the scheme, this panel has been formed by which agency? Ministry of Finance. Remember this thing. Now, okay, so I don't think I need the I need to read the options because you guys have already answered. Absolutely right. It's GK Pillai. And the year of formation is 2020. Absolutely right. Working group formed by RBI to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for co-investment companies. So this is a very important committee formed by RBI. So you have Tapan Das, Tapan Mehta, Tapan Ray, Tapan Chatterjee and Tapan Banerjee, who heads this co-investment companies group formed by RBI. Nidhi, the PDF will be provided to you on Infinity portal. So relax, just focus on the questions right now. Okay, it's option C, Tapan Ray, absolutely right. And the year of formation is 2019. Remember this thing. Which of the following committee has been formed for reviewing the MSME sector and to suggest reforms? So this is again an important committee. Nandan Nilekani Committee, Sunil Mehta Committee, UK Sinha, Usha Thurat or Alok Srivastav Committee. Which committee was formed to review the MSME sector? Padh lo yaar. Option C with them. Absolutely right, Akhil. It's option C, UK Sinha Committee, and the year is 2019. Who heads the Interministerial Steering Committee of National Mission on Transformative Mobility and Battery Storage? So you have in Jyoti Srinivas, राजीव कुमार, आलोक श्रीनिवास, मेहुल पारुलकर और अमिताभ कांत इन द ऑप्शंस हु हेड्स दिस कमिटी ऑन नेशनल मिशन ऑन ट्रांसफॉर्मेटिव मोबिलिटी एंड बैटरी स्टोरेज. Okay, so only one person has given the answer correctly. It's option E, Amitabh Kant, the CEO of Niti Aayog, and their formation is 2019. Okay, so match the following. We have a question on match the following. So you have been given the names of the committees and the year. So the first here we have Committee on Digital, the on deepening of digital payments, Competition Law Review Committee, Dhar Commission, Shah Commission. When was each of these commission formed? Tell me the answer. Akhilesh, my revision sessions are at 10 a.m. in the morning, and the morning test that I provide you for the daily current affairs is uploaded at 7 a.m. in the morning. Soch lo, aram se take your time and then answer me the right answer of this question. Good, it's option D. So let's see. Committee on Digital Payments was formed in the year 2019. Competition Law Review Committee was formed in the year 2018. Then we have Dhar Commission, which was formed in the year 1948, and Shah Commission was in the year 1977. So these are the years of formation of different committees. Next, who will head the committee formed to review the LPG market structure? Kirit Parekh, Shyam Banerjee, Prakash Javedkar, Dhyan Banegal, and then we have Mamata Banerjee. Who heads this LPG market structure committee? Yes, option D is correct. Nilesh, absolutely right, guys. Option D is correct. Absolutely right. It's Kirit Parekh, and 2019 is the year of formation. Kirit Parekh, LPG market structure, and this is one of the important committees because this committee has been formed in order to review the feasibility, to assess the feasibility of allowing private players in the LPG market. So that is why this one is very important and was in the news very much in the year 2019. Which of the following statement is true about Ramesh Chand Committee? So first of all, when was this Ramesh Chand Committee formed? In the year 2019. Now let us read the options to find out the purpose of this Ramesh Chand Committee. It was formed to suggest measures to curb bank frauds. It will suggest measures to improve FDIs. It was formed to develop the public credit registry. It will review the digital economy infrastructure. It will suggest measures to shift from WPI to PPI, that is from wholesale price index to producer price index. Tell me the right answer. ओके सो थ्री ओके सो डीएस यू हैव करेक्टली आस्क्ड दिस क्वेश्चन एट द राइट टाइम इन द अपकमिंग वेडनेसडे दैट इज अ डे आफ्टर टुमारो आई विल बी हैविंग अ सेशन ऑन जीडीपी प्रोजेक्शंस गिवन बाय डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस सो यू गाइस डोंट हैव टू क्रैम योर माइंड विद डिफरेंट जीडीपीस बिकॉज आई विल बी कमिंग विद अ सेशन ऑन जीडीपी फोरकास्ट फॉर इंडिया एज वेल एज द वर्ल्ड ऑन वेडनेसडे सो डोंट फॉरगेट टू बी देयर एट 10 एएम इन द मॉर्निंग Okay, so what happened, guys? Only three people have answered this question. What about the others? Okay, so let me tell you the right answer is option E. Ramesh Chand Committee was formed in order to suggest measures to the government to shift from WPI to PPI. So that is the right answer, and the year of formation is 2019. Do remember that. Who heads the Beekeeping Development Committee? Vivek Bhattacharji. Vivek Basu, Vivek Das, Vivek Devroy, or Vivek Chatterjee. So, which one is the right answer? Good. It's option D. Vivek Devroy. Who heads the 8-member steering committee to look into the development and regulation of financial technology sector in India? First of all, this committee was formed in the year 2018. Now we have Arvind Kuntia, Rajesh Dholakia, Manish Srivastav, Meena Parekh and Subhash Chandra Garg in the options. Which one is the right answer? Absolutely right. It's option E. Subhash Chandra Garg. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of SEBI's committee for developing corporate bond market by replacing Shyamala Gopinath? Basically, he was the earlier chairperson. Now, who has been appointed as the new chairperson of this committee? So you have Bimal Jalan, H.R. Khan, Y.G. Malikam, and Ajit Doval, or Aruna Sundaranjana, who has been appointed as a new chairperson of this committee. Okay, so Nilesh is saying C. What about other people? Now everyone has started with C. I hope, guys, you all are not following the herd mentality that if the one person has given the same answer, then everyone will give C. Use your brains and then tell me that who is the chairperson of this committee. I think, Amit, you have started to get bored, or is it more stretching? The session is more stretching. I think it's not okay. So it's 1 hour. A total of 100 questions are there. So you have to watch it till the end. No, guys, it's option B, H.R. Khan. So H.R. Khan got as the new chairman of this committee, which was formed in the year 2018. Choose the correct option. So you have been given the option, the names of the committees along with the chairperson. So you have to choose the right chairperson. So read the options and then tell me that which one is the correct option here. only one person has answered till now. Come on guys, give me your answers quickly. You don't have that much time while you are sitting in the examination. So tell me the answer quickly. Okay, so the only Nilesh, Rishabh and Vinay have given the right answer. It's option A, Committee on Economic Capital Framework, which is headed by Bimal Jalan, is the right match here. And the year of formation of Bimal Jalan Committee is 2018. Which of the following committee drafted the third Wildlife Action Plan? So K. Kasturi Ranjan Committee, J. C. Kala Committee, R. Gandhi Committee, Yashwant Thorat Committee, C. K. Mishra Committee. Which committee drafted this third National Wildlife Plan? Yes, Arnab. The important committees of 2018 as well as prior to 2018 are important. I'm not saying all the committees that have been formed by the government, RBI or SEBI are important, but the committees that have been formed for the major issues that are still in the news, the issues like financial technology, the issues like MSMEs. So the committees formed for those are important. For example, the committee formed on NPAs. So this committee was formed in the year 2018, Sunil Mehta Committee. But still it is important, it holds relevance in the present scenario as well. Absolutely right, it's JC Kala Committee. Which committee was formed to review foreign portfolio investments who were divesting from Indian markets? So this was formed in the year 2018. We have HR Khan Committee, K. Kasturi Ranjan, TV Mohandas Rai Committee, Primary Market Advisory Committee or Sunil Mehta Committee. So which committee has been formed to review the FPI investments that were divested from India? Vishali, the RBI notifications are covered by Tanvi ma'am in RBI 247. So RBI 247 is specifically for covering the finance news from phase 2 perspective, and in that sessions and the PDF, the RBI notifications are also covered. So Arnab, you should read 2019 committees as well. So I will provide you the PDF. PDF will be provided to the enrolled students only. But the committee's document is also there. So you can revise all the important committees through that document. It's option A, HR Khan Committee. National Digital Health Blueprint is the brainchild of which committee? So this is National Digital Health Blueprint. It's very important and you must have read about the committee as well. So now tell me the right person, the right name of the committee. So you have Rajiv Kumar Committee, J. Satyanarayan Committee, Biraj Kumar Committee, Balwant Rai Mehta Committee and Kothari Commission. Which of the following committee recommended or gave the idea of National Digital Health Mission? Come on, guys! National Digital Health Blueprint, National Digital Health Mission was very recently launched by, मतलब implemented by the Prime Minister or the Government of India. Arnab, so you will get the PDF of this PPT as well. So don't worry about the PDF. Just focus on the questions. Okay, so only Vivek has mentioned it. It's the J. Satyanarayan Committee, and I am at this question, so I am disappointed from you all because National Digital Health Mission was in 2020 only. So you should remember about the committee that suggested this National Digital Health Blueprint. It's J. Satyanarayan Committee. The year of formation is 2018. Who heads the committee formed to evaluate the amount of unclaimed PPF and post office savings and suggest whether it should go to the government treasury and or kept aside? So this committee is a very old committee. It was formed in 2014. So you have Timothy Goel Service, Pritam Singh, HR Khan, Sudarshan Singh and Harsh Malhotra. Which one is the right answer? Even if you guys don't remember the answer, then mention it here that we don't know or something like that. 2014, guys, it's 2014. DS, I have already mentioned this thing many times that in order to memorize MOUs, you should focus on the keywords. Obviously, you should keep in mind the whole scenario behind signing that MOU, the purpose, etc., etc. But whenever you are covering the MOU on actual basis for the examination, then you have to focus on the keywords. For example, dash party 1, party 2, signed MOU for this purpose. So in this manner, you can effectively revise the MOUs and you should also prepare your own notes regarding MOUs. So I have told this thing many times in the spotlight sessions as well that how you should remember MOUs better. Okay, so let me tell you the right answer here is option C, HR Khan. Next. Which of the following statement is incorrect about Monetary Policy Committee? So this committee was formed in the year 2016 and I don't think that I need to tell you how important Monetary Policy Committee is for the upcoming examination. So now let us read out all the options and find out which one is the incorrect option. Central government has constituted MPC in accordance with the powers conferred under the section 45ZB of RBI Act. MPC aims to spur economic growth by setting or changing the benchmark rates as the need arises. Option C. It consists of 6 members, 3 from RBI and 3 appointed by the central government. Option D. It is responsible for maintaining price stability. Option E. MPC conducts its meetings 6 times in a year and publishes the decisions later on. Which one is the incorrect statement about MPC? then it's well and good, yes, if you're making short notes about the MOUs, and I don't think that then you should face any difficulty in memorizing the MOUs. Just be sure that you only focus on the keywords. Okay, so Shilpa has given her answer. Is anybody there who want to answer this question? Then please, guys, mention your answers here. Okay, absolutely right. It's option E. It is incorrect because the meetings are conducted 4 times in a year, not 6. Who has been appointed as the head of the committee which has been set up to deepen the digital payments? So this is an important committee. I will tell you why is it so important a minute later. But before that, I would like to hear the answers from you. Who is the chairperson of this committee? K.K. Venugopal, Nandan, Nilekani, Ashish Kumar Chauhan, Rishabh Premji, or Vivek Debroy? Okay. Absolutely right. It's Nandan Nilekani. In the year 2019, it was formed. Now, guys, if you remember that recently Digital Payment Index was released by RBI, so that index was also suggested by Nandan Nilekani committee. So if a question comes on the examination that which committee suggested or recommended RBI to prepare Digital Payment Index, then you will answer Nandan Nilekani committee. When was the steering committee tasked to implement National Clean Air Program formed? 2017, 18, 19, 15 or 14? And the chairperson of this committee is C.K. Mishra. Absolutely right, Shilpa. 207.84 was the score of India in March 2020 according to Digital Payment Index. Good. Vishal, they are mandated to meet they are mandated to meet 4 times in a year, but they meet every 2 months. This is because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Yes, Shilpa, that was the score, 207.84. Good. It's 2019 and the chairperson is C.K. Mishra. What is the objective of Vayam Vyosthali Committee? Public credit registry to curb custodial debts, changes in FRBM, that is fiscal responsibility and budget management, double farmers income by 2022 and UGC 7th pay commission. So which one is the objective of this committee? Which was formed in the year 2017. So this is again an important committee formed in 2017. Hello Ishu. So I guess you have again joined late in the session. Come on guys, tell me the answer of this question. This is an important committee, Vayam Vyosthali Committee. Absolutely right, guys. It's to prepare the public credit registry. For that purpose, this Vayam Vyosthali Committee was formed in the year 2017. Which committee was formed for preparing guidelines for desalination of Ganga River? So it was in 2016. Keshav Chandra Committee, Madhav Chitle Committee, Uday Kotak, P.K. Sinha, Usha Nath Banerjee. Which committee was formed for desalination of Ganga River? Tell me the answer. Monica, which committee are you asking me? Public registry committee ka head is YM Diyosthale. Only. Absolutely right. It's option B. Madhav Chitle committee in 2016. What is the purpose of B.N. Shri Krishna Committee formed in 2017? So you have data protection in digital economy, AIFF disputes, institutionalization of arbitration, both A and B, both A and C. So tell me the right answer. B.N. Shri Krishna Committee. Arnab, it will help you because I am telling the answers of these questions, so it will in a way help you in memorizing these questions. So if you want to have a track of all the questions and memorize the committees that you have not till now, then you should watch this session till the end. It's option C, both A and C. Data protection in digital economy and institutionalization of arbitration. For both these purposes, this committee, B.N. Shri Krishna Committee, was formed in 2017. Match the committee with its purpose. So you have the committees, you have the purpose. Read the question carefully and then give me the answer. Okay, so Suhas has mentioned the answer, Akhil has mentioned his answer, but what about the other people? Read the question carefully, then tell me the answer. Yes, yes, Shilpa, therefore this session is important for your phase 1 as well as phase 2 of the RBI Grade B examination. Even for that matter, committees are asked in NABARD and SEBI examination also. So since the exam, the upcoming SEBI exam, for that it is also important. Absolutely right, guys. It's option C. That is, K. Kasturi Ranjan Committee was for National Education Policy. B. R. Sharma Committee was for playing the national anthem in cinemas. Amitabh Kant Committee was for NPS in power sector. Then we have Balram Bhargav Committee for preparing to review the national list of essential medicines. And K. Rajeshwar Rao Committee to review the National Mineral Policy 2008. So these are the right match. The recommendations of the 15th Finance Commission would be applicable from which year? So you have been given the different years. Tell me the recently 15th Finance Commission has submitted its report as well. So tell me for which tenure will the recommendation be applicable? Absolutely right, Shilpa. It's option B for FY22 to FY26, and the year of formation of 15th Finance Commission is 2017. Good. इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजरी काउंसिल टू प्राइम मिनिस्टर. सो यू हैव विवेक देबरॉय, वी कामकोटी, कदियम श्रीहरि, पी के सिन्हा, राजीव गोबा. हु इज द हेड ऑफ इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजरी काउंसिल टू द प्राइम मिनिस्टर? Yes, it's option A. Vivek Debaroy and PK Sinha is the cabinet secretary. Which of the following is the expert group on SECC, Social Economic Caste Census? So you have K Bajaj Committee, Abhinav Bindra Committee, Sumit Bose Committee, Ashok Dalwai Committee, and N Mishra Committee. Which committee is the group on SECC, or which committee was formed for socio-economic caste census? And remember, the year of formation is 2016. So guys, I have taken only the most important committees of older years. Now tell me that which committee was for SECC. It's Sumit Bose. So Akhil has given the answer correctly. Very good, Akhil. It's Sumit Bose Committee, and 2016 is the year. Which committee has suggested the project Sashakt for reducing the soaring NPAs of PSBs, public sector banks? Subhash Chandra Garg Committee, Vinesh Sheen, Oberoi Committee, N. Gopal Swami, Sunil Mehta, or Umesh Sinha? Which committee suggested the project Sashakt? This is important, guys. Project Sashakt. Okay. So I am feeling relieved that you guys answered this question, because otherwise I would have disappointed at you very much. Sunil Mehta Committee, absolutely right. It's Project Sashakt. 2018 is the year of formation of this committee. Now this question is more relevant for your phase 2 examination, because such kind of statement based questions are asked in the phase 2. So do listen to me very carefully in this question. Which of the following statement is incorrect about Project Sashakt? Bad loans of up to rupees 50 crore will be managed at the bank level with a deadline of 90 days. For bad loans of 50 to 500 crores, bank will enter an inter-credited creditor agreement authorizing the lead bank to implement a resolution plan in 180 days. For loans above 500 crore, the panel recommended to establish an independent asset management company. Committee, asset management committee will be supported by the institutional funding through the alternative investment fund. Board of directors of PSBs must recruit an independent supervisory officer for reviewing the exposures of the bank. So which one is the right answer? So guys, I'm giving you 2 minutes to read the entire question on your own and then tell me the answer. Okay, so now I hope that you have read the question carefully. Tell me your answers. Shilpa and Sumit are giving their answers, but what about other people? ओके सो द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन ई. बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ पीएसबीज मस्ट रिक्रूट एन इंडिपेंडेंट सुपरवाइजरी ऑफिसर फॉर रिव्यूइंग द एक्सपोजर्स ऑफ द बैंक. दिस वाज नॉट रिकमेंडेड बाय द कमिटी ऑन प्रोजेक्ट सशक्त एंड ऑल दीज फोर आर द रिकमेंडेशंस अंडर प्रोजेक्ट सशक्त. So next question is again a statement based question. Which of the following statement is not recommended by our Gandhi Committee on Market Infrastructure Institutions in its 2018 report? So this our Gandhi Committee was formed in the year 2017. I'm giving you again 2 seconds to read the question carefully and then give me your answers. So I hope guys that you have you have read the question carefully. Now tell me the answer. The right answer to this question is option B. That is, this committee, the R. Gandhi Committee, did not recommend to create this central repository of data, and the other four options are the right recommendations of R. Gandhi Committee. What is the name of the committee formed to keep an eye on midday meal served to students in state-run primary schools to ensure that they get nutritious food prepared in hygienic conditions? So this was formed in the year 2017. Now which committee was it? Shamta, Maitri, Ma, Poshan, Swasthya. Which committee was formed for midday meal? So everyone is going with पोषण. पोषण अभियान चल रहा है इसलिए गेस वर्क कर रहे हो और यू आर ट्रांसलेटिंग न्यूट्रिशन इन हिंदी एज पोषण. Therefore you are going with पोषण. It's Maa Committee. Poshan is Abhiyan. Poshan Abhiyan and the committee for midday meal is Maa Committee in 2017. What is the name of the commission formed to examine the distribution of benefits of sub-castes which fall under the criteria of other backward castes? So this commission, this committee is in the news and recently it has got extension of 6 months and now you have to tell me the name of this committee. And I think that I should not get wrong answers here because this committee has been discussed by me as well, by Manish sir as well in his PIB 247. So tell me the right answer. So DS, you used translation. Very good. But that is not always correct. Okay, so the right answer of this question, tell me guys. Absolutely right, it's Rohini Commission. And in the year 2017 it was formed. Who heads the inter-regulatory working group on fintech and digital banking? Nandan Nilekani, Uma Bharati, Yashwant Thorat, Sudarshan Sen and Damodar Das. And this one was formed in the year 2016, Inter-Regulatory Working Group. Tell me the answer. Only 100 questions are there in this PPT and we are on 82 guys. So quickly, come on, jaldi jaldi answers do, taki jaldi jaldi hum log sare questions cover kare. Tell me the answer of this question. Okay. Okay, I guess you don't know the answer of this question. It's D, Sudarshan Sen. So this highlights that you have not prepared the committees thoroughly. Guys, all the important committees prior to 2020 are also important, and I hope this session helps you in remembering all those committees. Good, it's Sudarshan Sen. Bimal Jalan committee. So this committee suggested, it's gave its recommendation, and all the recommendations regarding the regarding giving surplus to the government, and this was very much in the news. So here I would like you to remember the recommendations of this committee as well, Bimal Jalan committee. Now let us read the questions. So the Bimal Jalan committee on economic capital framework has recently recommended a method to distribute profits of RBI to the government. Which among the following is a correct recommendation? So these are the different recommendations of realized equity of RBI. So read the options and then tell me the answer. Okay, so only two answers. What about the other people? You're welcome, Shilpa. But this Bimal Jalan committee is an important committee, and all the recommendations of this committee, you should prepare the recommendations. That is my take here. Absolutely right, guys. It's option C. Realized equity should be maintained at 5.5 to 6.5% of total assets of RBI. Next is again about the recommendation of Economic Capital Framework Committee. So you have to again identify the correct statement with respect to the committee. So you have been given the options. Identify the correct statement. What happened, guys? Quickly tell me the answer. Okay, so four people have answered this question. What about the others? 64 people are watching this. Correct statement find out karna hai, guys. And why are the people saying B? This is, we have just covered, it's 5.5 to 6.5. So this question, this option should be eliminated. I don't think, why are you saying option B is correct? Absolutely, Suhas, you got it right. You got the catch. It's not every year. So this statement is also wrong. And these two though are absolutely wrong, because this committee is headed by Bimal Jalan. So what is the remaining statement? It's option C. It is the right statement. Economic capital level should be maintained at 24.5%. So this question is, I don't think we need to cover it. Economic capital framework, it's Bimal Jalan, we have already discussed it. 2018 is the year of formation. Which of the following committee was formed by Andhra Pradesh to suggest the model for Andhra Pradesh development? So this committee was in 2019. You have G.N. Rao committee, K.C. Shiva Ramakrishnan committee, B. Rajendranath committee, K.T. Rama Rao committee, and V. Sita Ram committee. Tell me the exact answer. Now let me tell you why this committee was in news, because of the three capital formula that Andhra Pradesh is adopting, and it was in the news, I guess, in 2019 very much, when the three capital formula was implemented and the land was captured from the people.
हेलो हेलो
Okay guys, so tell me the answer of this question. It's G.N. Rao guys. And Akhil has mentioned it correctly. It's G.N. Rao, absolutely right, Akhil. It was formed in 2019. Who heads the Trade Promotion Council of India's Committee on Food Processing Technology? Manish Shah, Geeta Porwar, Manav Dang, and R. Senguthuan and Rohit Kumar are in the options. Which one is the right answer? Committee on Food Processing Technology. And again, guys, the agency that has formed this committee is also important, that is Trade Promotion Council of India. The year of formation is 2020. So this is again a recent committee and I expect answers from you. So answer this question. It's option B, R. Senguthuan. He is the head of this committee on food processing technology. Who heads the committee formed by government for transforming the Indian Academy of Highway Engineers into a world-class premier institute on highway sector? So this question we have discussed, it's Y.S. Malik. Who heads the municipal bonds committee formed by SEBI to find out ways for the development of primary and secondary market of municipal debt securities? So it's option A, Sujit Prasad. This question was also discussed. Okay. Who heads the Committee on Trade and Policy formed by Ministry of Commerce and Industry in 2018 to boost India's share and importance in global merchandise and services trade in the challenging world scenario? This is an important committee formed in the year 2018, mentioned in the question itself. Now you have Abhinav Gupta, Sadanand, Agam Mittal, B. Madan Mohan Das, Surjit Bhalla. Who is the head of this committee on trade and policy? So we are on question number 90 and only 10 questions are remaining in the session. So do listen to me very carefully, guys. Okay. So you don't know Gajraj, but what about other people? Don't you know the answer of this question? Okay, so the right answer is option E, Surjit Bhalla. Who heads the Competition Law Review Committee? So 2018 was the year in which this was formed. Atul Mishra, Rajiv Kumar, Atanu Chakrabarti, Injeti Srinivas, Parul Mishra. Competition Law Review Committee. Ye wala to, you guys know the answer of this question. You should know the answer of this question. Competition Law Review Committee. ओके सो यू डोंट नो द आंसर. इट्स ऑप्शन बी इंजेती श्रीनिवास. ही इज द चेयरपर्सन ऑफ दिस कॉम्पिटिशन लॉ रिव्यू कमिटी. 2018 इज द ईयर ऑफ फॉर्मेशन. हु हेड्स द कमिटी ऑन स्पेशल इकोनॉमिक जोन्स. ईयर ऑफ फॉर्मेशन इज 2018. सो यू हैव आशीष मेहता, राजीव गोबा, बाबा कल्याणी एंड रोमेश सोबती, एच आर खान. हु हेड्स दिस कमिटी? Absolutely right, Akhil. Akhil is saying Injiti Srinivas is the chair of IFSCA, International Financial Services Centers Authority. Absolutely right. So this is another fact that you should remember. Good, so you remember the answer. It's option C, Baba Kalyani, Committee on Special Economic Zones. Where was the N. Chandrasekharan Task Force formed for reviewing the application of artificial intelligence in military? N. Chandrasekharan. So, when was this committee formed? The answer is 2018. The answer of this question is 2018. Next. Who heads the expert committee on rationalization of film media units and expert committee on review of autonomous bodies? So basically these two committees have the same chairperson. Now who is that person? You have the five options right in front of you. Tell me the right answer. Okay, good. Shilpa, it's option A, Bimal Julka. Who heads the group of ministers on Me Too? Narendra Modi, Ravi Shankar Prasad, Thavar Chand Gehlot, Amit Shah, Smriti Irani. Who heads this group of ministers on Me Too? Good. It's option D, Amit Shah, Home Minister. When was the Fazal Commission formed? So these are the years 2001, 1989, 1990, 2011, 1953. Now let's read out this portion. Chairperson is Fazal Ali and the purpose is reorganization of states. That's why this commission is important and is here in the session. So when was this Fazal Commission formed? You have to tell the year. Okay, so you remember. Shweta, Vishal, Shilpa have given the right answer. It's 1953. Absolutely right. When was Narsingham Committee 2 formed? So this is an important committee for the banking and capital markets reform. So when was this committee formed? You have been given the different years. Tell me the exact year in which this committee, Narsingham Committee 2, was formed. Yeah, nursing home committee is for banking reforms, and you should not do this thing. You don't even remember the year of formation of this committee, which is for banking reforms. If you are going for banking examination, this is not done, guys. You should memorize important committees like nursing home committee, which is specifically formed for the banking reforms. Okay, so the 1998 option A is the right answer. Who heads the technical advisory committee formed by National Financial Reporting Authority? So you have the five options. Tell me the head of this committee. And the year of this committee is 2020. So this committee was formed in 2020 only. Tell me the person. The right answer is option D, R. Narayan Swami. Who is the head of committee for analysis of QR code? So the committee has recently submitted its recommendation in the year 2020. Now who heads this committee? These are the options. Tell me the right answer. The year of formation of this committee is 2019. Absolutely right. It's Deepak Pathak is the chair of this committee. Who heads RBI's committee for reviewing the ways and means advances limits for state and union territories? So this was formed in the year 2020, and this is one of the most important committees formed by RBI. Now tell me the chairperson of this committee. Good. Suhas, it's option A, Sudhir Srivastav. So guys, here this session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed, and the older committees, you will be able to memorize them and remember all the older committees. Thank you so much for watching the session. If you have any queries, then you can ask me. I'm waiting for your queries so that I can resolve them. Welcome all you guys. I hope that the sessions that we provide on our channel help you in memorizing the things better and give you a clear idea about the concepts, because we believe in clarifying the concepts only. Okay. PDF. Okay, so this is the last time I'm telling you guys, the PDF will be provided in the revision folder as well as in the static GK folder to the enrolled students. So that's all for this session, and I think that all the queries of you guys have been resolved. And okay, so there is one. श्वेता इफ यू हैव नॉट डन इट टिल नाउ देन जस्ट लीव ऑल द कमिटीज जस्ट फोकस ऑन द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कमिटीज फॉर्मड इन द ईयर 2021 ऑल द कमिटीज फॉर्मड इन द ईयर 2021 फॉर्मड इन द ईयर 2020 एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कमिटीज विच वर फॉर्मड अ ईयर एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो लुक एट दिस सेशन फॉर योर रिविजन एट अ लेटेस्ट स्टेज एज वेल So that's all. Just don't go into all the committees because now you don't have that much time. Yes, DS GDP projection class will be on Wednesday. So all of you guys who want to cover the GDPs for the upcoming examination should be there, should be on Wednesday on 10 at 10 p.m. Should be there on YouTube. Okay. Thank you guys. Thank you so much for watching this session. Thank you.